Test, test, 1, 2. Can you hear me? Yeah. Test, 1, 2. Okay, good.
Good evening. Welcome to the TCP Live. I am just so delighted that you're with us tonight here, and I'm just so delighted to be able to share the Word of God with you. And as you come into our virtual family tonight, into our virtual sanctuary, as we like to call it, don't forget to speak to one another. Yes, speak to one another. Say how to do. Glad you're here. I saw your name. If you don't know someone, speak to them. And don't forget to like us. Send us a lot of hearts, a lot of love too. And if you have not subscribed to us on YouTube, please do that. And then hit that bell so that whenever we send out notifications, you will be the first one that will be notified. And I'm going to ask you to also follow us on Instagram. With the connecting place. Let's stay connected. That's really what it's about. It's about staying connected. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. All right, come on in. I don't want to leave anyone behind on tonight. Well, let's have a word of prayer. Lord, we thank you for tonight. We thank you for this is the day that you have made, and we are rejoicing, and we are glad in it. We thank you, God, for just giving us the activities of our limbs and the articulation of our speech. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you for loving us enough, God, to give us the strength that we need to keep going forward, to keep moving. And so tonight, as we go to your word, Lord, tonight, I thank you for opening up our understanding, giving us grace to stand, and giving us a resolve, a confidence in you, that you who have begun a good work in us is faithful to complete it in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And we bless you, Lord. Amen. Well, we praise God for you. I trust you've had a great week thus far. It is the middle of the week, and I pray that you are abounding in the things of the Lord. That's my prayer for you, that you are abounding in the things of the Lord Jesus Christ. Well, you know, we started a series a couple of weeks ago, and it's entitled, I Dare You. I Dare You. And we've been blessed, I believe, for the last several weeks in this particular teaching. And dare means that I'm speaking to you to do something you may not have ever done that you need to do. And I dare you to do it. And tonight, I want to talk with you about I dare you to be bold. I dare you to what? To be bold. And what is bold? Boldness is courage to do what I have to do. It is courage to do what you have to do. Boldness is not a feeling, because there are times you don't feel like it. Boldness has nothing to do with some special kind of force that happens to you. But boldness is a courage, 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 courage. And courage is a it is a decision to do what I have to do. Yes. So when it talks about be bold, it says, you know what? Be courageous to do what you have to do. Be bold. I've got to do what I have to do. I have no other choice. I'm called to this. I've got to do it. If I don't do it, it won't get done. I just have to be courageous enough to do it. And go with me, if you will, to Joshua chapter 1. Joshua chapter 1. Joshua chapter 1. It's a very familiar text of scripture. And let's take a look at verse number 2. Moses, my servant, is dead. Now, therefore, arise and go over this Jordan, you and all of this people, to the land which I am given to them, the children of Israel. I want you to go and possess a place that already belongs to you. Verse 3, every place that that the sole of your feet will tread upon, I have given to you, as I said to Moses. In other words, I have already put winning on your side. I need you to just walk through the process. Look at verse 4. From the wilderness and this Lebanon as far as the great river, the river Euphrates, all the land of the Hittites, and the great sea toward the going down of the sun shall be your territory. Look at verse 5. This is the Lord speaking to Joshua. No man shall be able to stand before you all the days of your life. As I was with Moses, so I will be with you, and I will not leave you nor forsake you. Now, this is the Lord building the confidence of Joshua, because you are about to experience something, but you need something to rest upon. You need a level of confidence to rest upon. So the Lord is reassuring him, just like I was with Moses, and you seen the wonders, and you seen my hand at work with Moses, you can be assured of the same hand of God with you. Look at verse 6. Be strong and of good courage, for to this people you shall divide as an inheritance the land which I swore to their fathers to give them. Only be strong and very courageous, he's saying it again, that you may observe to do according to all the law which Moses, my servant, commanded you. Do not turn from it to the right nor to the left, that you may prosper wherever you go. The book of the law shall not depart from your mouth, but you shall meditate in this book day and night, and you shall observe to do according to all that is written in it. For then you shall make your way prosperous, and then you will have good success. Have I not commanded you? Be strong and of a good courage. Woo, my God. And do not be afraid nor be dismayed, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. That's powerful. Three distinctive times the Lord says to Joshua, what? Be strong and what? Very courageous. What? Be strong and what? Very courageous. Three times the Lord reminds him to be strong. Three times the Lord reminds him to be strong. If you're going to be bold, boldness takes what I call retooling. Boldness takes or requires retooling. And what does it mean to retool? Retool deals with rearranging. It deals with replacing something with something better, updating for another level of efficacy and efficiency. It means that I no longer operate on one level. I choose to operate on a better level, doing something better. So when you talk about retooling, it says that I'm going to replace something with something else that's better. I'm going to replace something else That's better. And so if you're going to be bold, you have to retool. What am I retooling? What am I replacing? What am I rearranging? I am replacing fear with what? I am replacing fear with what? With faith. In other words, I am replacing fear and doubt and uncertainty with strength and courage. I am replacing fear and doubt and uncertainty with strength and with courage. Hallelujah. In other words, fear says that I refuse to move. I am immobilized. I refuse to do it. I don't want to do it. I'm afraid. So when I'm afraid, I don't move. It stops my movement. I am replacing fear and a lack of movement with courage and movement. Strength to move and courage to do it. In other words, when you start retooling, you have to replace something with something else. I have to replace this lack of courage with boldness. I have to replace inactivity or the inability to move with boldness to move. I have to replace this. I cannot stay this way. And three times the Lord tells Joshua, you have to be strong and of good courage. You have to be strong enough to move. You have to be strong enough to be bold. And that's what God is requiring of you in this season. You and I, we have to be bold. You have to stop allowing intimidation to break you down and to cause you not to become who God has called you to be. And you have to no longer allow the intimidation of others or even the bigness of the problem or the bigness of the issue to cause you to shrink down in doing what you have to do. Look at what the Lord told Joshua. The Lord says to him, you have to recognize that I've already given it to you. Hallelujah. I have already given the very thing you're going after, what you want to become, what you are pursuing me concerning. I have already placed it within your reach. In fact, it's yours already. My God, the promise is yours already. What you're going after, it's yours already. It is within your reach. But could it be you've stopped reaching? It is within your reach. Could it be that you have stopped reaching? You've stopped reaching. And one thing I want you to know, my brothers and sisters, the Lord rewards reachers. You cannot touch it if you stop reaching. You cannot become it if you stop reaching. You cannot do it if you stop reaching. The Lord rewards reachers. I'm going to say that again. The Lord rewards reachers. If you want to see the promise of God, you want to see the fulfillment of what you're going after, you have to keep reaching. What did Paul say in the book of Philippians? I am reaching for those things that are ahead of me. I'm forgetting those things that are behind me, and I'm reaching for those things. I am reaching for those things. I am extending myself toward those things that are ahead of me. I press toward the mark. I press toward the mark. I reach and I press in with effort. I reach and I press. Could it be you stop reaching and you stop pressing in because you've lost your boldness? You've lost your courage. Hallelujah. So right now, I speak to your boldness. I speak to your boldness right now. I speak to your boldness. You are not a weakling. You might have lost that battle, but you're not a weakling. You may not have come through like you wanted to come through, but you are not a weakling. You refuse to get out of the race. My God, though everybody else is passing you, you refuse to get out of the race. Why? Because the Lord has already brought you to the place. He's already given it to you. And so I speak to you today to retool. If you're going to be bold, you have to retool. There's some things you will have to replace. You will have to replace negativity. You will have to Replace the greater influence of others in your mind, in your thought process, and it has to be replaced with what the Lord has said. You've got to do some retooling. You've got to look in your toolbox and make a decision. What tools do you have that's no longer good for you, that's no longer working for you? It might have worked at one season in your life, but now where you're going, we're in a new age, we're in a new technology world, it's not going to work now. It might have worked at one time, but it's not going to work now. At one point, an 8-cartridge tape worked good, but it's not going to work now. You've got to use an MP now. It worked at one time, but it's not going to work now. You've got to look at what you're working with and make that decision. Is it going to work for me now? The company that I'm keeping, is it going to work for me now? The mindset that I've been operating under, is it going to work for me now? The way that I have been handling my business, spending my money, is it going to work for me now? What I'm going after, the company that I'm keeping, the environment that I'm keeping, the mindset that I have, what I've been reading, what I've been looking at, is it going to work for me now? It might require a retooling in your life. It might require you to replace it. And I want to say, you not only do you need courage to do it, but you need courage to rise up and to begin to retool. You need courage to rise up and to begin to retooling, because retooling does not, rather your boldness is hooked to your ability to retool. When you see where you want to be and you see the greater side that God is calling you to, and you get an understanding of what you sense God has laid in your life and the better and the improvement that God has spoken concerning you, my brothers and sisters, your next question ought to be, God, how do I get there? How do I do it? Hallelujah. When you discover what God's best for you, when you discover the will of God for your life, when you discover God has spoken better concerning you, when you discover that how you started out is not how you have to end, your next question ought to be, how can I become it? How can I get there? How can I do it? And here the Lord says to Joshua, you have to be courageous and you have to be strong. You have to be strengthened with my might and you have to be bold. You have to be bold. You have to emerge out of your hiding place. You have to emerge out of the shadows and be bold. You want that job? You got to be bold. You want that career? You have to be bold. You want to become better? You have to be bold. My God, you have to begin to take some bold steps. Did you hear what I said? You have to begin to take some bold steps. I've never done that before. You have to begin to take some bold steps. I've never been there before. You have to now begin to make some bold steps. Walk into some bold doors. Yes, God, hallelujah. Yeah, connect to some bold people. My God, I know it's out of your normalcy. It's out of the group you normally being with. My God, it's out of you. It sort of puts you in the posture that you said, I've never done this before. But you know what? Where you're going, you've never been there before. That means I've got to do what I've never done if I want to get to where I'm going. You have to be bold. Somebody said, be bold. You have to be bold and be not dismayed and do not be afraid, for the Lord is with you. Wherever you go, the Lord is with you. The Lord is with you. God is working out the details of your life, but you have to be bold enough to start moving toward the very thing that you want to become, toward the very thing you want to move in light of. So you have to be bold. You have to be bold. Be bold, be strong, for the Lord our God is with you. Do not be afraid. And so I speak to your fear. I speak to your doubt. I speak to your past that keeps trying to hold you in, that keeps trying to stop you from moving. I speak to it. I denounce it in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We call that thing out. Hallelujah. We denounce it. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Your past, my God. All those negative words that were spoken over you by your family, by your mother, by your father, by your ex-husband, by your ex-wife, by your friend, by your sorority friend, by your fraternity brother that spoke that negativity over you, that has shrouded your life, we break the hold of it in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We break it right now. We bind it. My. We bind it right now. Hallelujah. We bind it right now in the name of Jesus. We bind it right now. And so we speak to that strength, that inner strength. We speak to the power of the Holy Spirit that's on the inside of you. And we say in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, come forth, come forth, come forth, come forth, dream, come forth, promise, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Come forth, come forth, come forth like a mighty rushing wind. Come forth in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. I come against your timidity. I speak against it right now. I speak against your cowardness. I speak against it right now. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I come against it right now. I speak against it right now. I speak against it right now. I speak against your small-mindedness right now. I speak against it right now. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I speak to you. I speak boldness in your hands. I speak boldness in your thoughts. I speak it in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And I say to you, as God said to Joshua, be strong, be courageous, be bold, do what you have to do. If you got to rise up early in the morning, then get up early in the morning. If you got to stay up all night long to get it done, you stay up all night long to get it done. If you got to work overtime while others are out to play, you do what you have to do. You got to be bold enough to do it. Hallelujah. You got to be bold enough to do it. If you're bold, God will give you strength. Hallelujah. My. If you're bold, God will open up a door for you. If you're bold, God will send help for you. If you're bold, God will give you strength out of Zion and help out the sanctuary. If you're bold, God will send people to come along your path and to undergird you. But you have to be strong and you have to be courageous. Hallelujah. My. You got to be bold. You got to be bold. You have to speak boldness into your own spirit. David said, I encouraged myself in the Lord. They were trying to take my life, but I had to speak life to my life. My God, hallelujah. You can't expect the oppressor. You can't expect the demonizer. You can't expect the one who has brought you into captivity to speak life to you. David said, when they came to kill me, they came to take my life away. I encouraged myself in the Lord. I spoke to myself. Hallelujah. I spoke courage to myself. I spoke boldness to myself. The Lord is with me. The Lord is my shepherd. The Lord is my shield. The Lord is my buckler. Oh, I shall not want. The Lord is with me. The Lord is with me. And I exalt him and I extol him. You need to be bold, my brother. You need to be bold, my sister. If you take bold steps, I'm here to tell you that a great big God is there to hold you up. If you're willing to make those bold steps, my God, God will never allow you to make a step that he's not there to catch you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. He said, do not be afraid. Do not be dismayed. I am with you. I am with you. I am with you to hold you. I am with you to carry you. I am with you, but I need you to retool. Hallelujah. I need you to change the tools you've been working with in your toolbox. And I need you to sharpen yourself, sharpen your skill set, sharpen who you are, and be bold when it's time for you to be released. Hallelujah. Be bold, be strong, for the Lord our God is with you. Hallelujah. Be strong. Be bold, hallelujah. Be strong and be bold, for the Lord our God is with you. Be strong and be courageous. Be bold, the Lord is with you. I know you've been hurt, but be bold and get up and do it again. I know you've been disappointed, but be bold. Get up and go do it again. Be bold, be bold, be bold, be bold. Be bold. Make the phone call. Do what you have to do. Supply the application. Supply the resume. Be bold. Be bold. Be bold. Stand. Stand. Yes. Stand. 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 Goliath said to David, how do you know you can whip me? And David stood up with a slingshot and five smooth stones in his hand and said, I know I'm able to beat you. He was bold. Do you think I'm a dog? Do you think I'm a kid? That you've come to play with me, to toy with me, as little as you are and as big as I am? Hallelujah. David was bold. He was courageous. He stood in the strength of God. He stood in what he knew about God. And he asked him, how do you know that you can whip me? How do you know you can win? And David said, I remember when. See, when you are bold, you have a frame of reference. When you are bold, you stand not in your own strength. You stand in the strength of Almighty God. You stand in the awareness of Almighty God. You stand in who God is. And David said, I remember when I was keeping my daddy's sheep and the lions came in and the bears came in to take my daddy's lamb, to take my daddy's sheep. I took my stick and I hit the animal in the head. I hit the lion in the head. I hit the bear in the head and took my staff and grabbed the lion and rather grabbed the lamb and grabbed the sheep and rescued them. Hallelujah. My God, my assignment was on the line. My assignment was to watch my daddy's lambs and my daddy's sheep, but the enemy came in and tried to take it. And I wasn't going to let the enemy come in and cause my assignment to be aborted and my assignment to go down defeated. So I stood up against the enemy. I was bold to stand. He was on 4 feet, but I was on 2, but I had a bold God. I was standing because I knew God was able to stand with me. In my own might, I couldn't do it. But in the strength of God, I can do it. The Lord is looking for you to make a move, my brother, my sister. The Lord is looking for you to make a move. And if you're willing enough to make that bold move, our God will move heaven and earth to move on your behalf. God will move heaven and earth to cause things to happen for you. And because David was willing to stand for the lambs, God was willing to stand with David. I'm going to say that again. Because David was willing to stand with the lambs and the sheep. Good God. God was willing to stand with David. Hallelujah. If you're bold to do what you have to do, God will stand with you. If you are bold to do what you have to do, God will stand with you. Hallelujah. Glory to God. God will stand with you. My God, I feel God right here. Lord, have mercy. I feel the Holy Spirit right now. If you are bold to do what you have to do, God will stand with you. If you are bold to do what you have to do, what you are required to do, and you don't shrink back from it, God will stand with you in the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. 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 So now we cancel out the thought in your mind of the enemy telling you God is not going to stand with you and God's not going to be with you. When you're bold to do what you have to do because it is your assignment to do it, because you're called to it, because this is the will of God concerning you, if you're willing to do it, God will stand with you in the name of the Lord. And so I dare you to be bold. 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 I dare you to be bold in your business. I dare you to set the goal. I dare you to do it. I dare you to do it. I failed before, but I dare you to do it this time because now you're going back with another resolve, with a new plan, with a new idea, with a new spirit. I dare you to do it. I dare you to do it. And know that God is with me. As I was with Moses, so shall I be with you. Just like I was with them, I'll be with you. Lord Jesus, thank you for your word tonight. Hallelujah. Your word is pure. Your word is powerful. Your word is encouraging. Your word is uplifting. Your word causes us to rest. Your word, God, helps us to get through the Reubenites and get through the Gadites and get through the sons of Manasseh. Your word, God, helps us to rest, to cease from labor. Your word, God, causes vision to return. Your word, God, gives might to our weakness. Your word. Thank you, God. Thank you. Thank you for infusing us tonight. And I thank you for the calm assurance in our heart that as you was with Moses, you'll be with me. As you was with Moses, Lord, you were with Joshua. And Lord, as you were with Joshua, I know you'll be with me in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And I thank you tonight for boldness. I thank you tonight for the courage to do what I have to do. I thank you for strength to do it in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I thank you because our strength is in the name of the Lord. And we stand on your word tonight in the name of the Lord that you're with us. 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 You're with us in the name of the Lord. We stand upon your word. We are reminded of your word. We have confidence in your word, for your word becomes the foundation that we settle ourselves on, and we move in boldness in light of the truth of your word. We bless you tonight in Jesus' name. If you don't know Jesus Christ as your Lord and as your Savior tonight, I want to introduce you to Jesus. I want to introduce you to Jesus. Yes, I want to introduce you to Jesus. Jesus loves you. Jesus says to you, I love you the way you are. You don't have to get better to receive me, saith Jesus. No, you just come as you are and just say, Lord, here I am. Forgive me of my sins. Come into my life. Make me new. Straighten me out. Make me better. Cause your glory. Cause your life to be lived through me. Forgive me of my sins and make me new. And I receive you in Jesus' name. Amen. If you prayed that prayer according to Romans chapter 10, according to the confession of your faith, the Bible says you're saved. Yes, you're saved. You're saved. That means your life, your sins are forgiven. Your life is on a new path, and now you can grow a different way. I'm going to ask you, if you're not a member of a church, you can call our office 704-399-5448, and one of our prayer warriors would be so delighted to talk with you and to help you get started right. If you are a member of a church, call your pastor, call your leader, call someone from the church and let them know you gave your life to Jesus so that you can now get started right and allow your brothers and sisters in the Lord to help you to grow in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. I'm so glad that you're with us tonight. Listen, I want you to mark your calendars for Sunday, October the 18th through, I think it's Saturday, October the 31st, I believe. That's 14 days of times of prayer. This will be our fasting and a season of fasting and prayer. And for 14 days, we're going to have prayer, virtual prayer here at the church, or I shouldn't say not at the church, but we will virtually have prayer every day at 7 o'clock starting on the 18th through the 31st. We'll have various prayer leaders. I'll be leading the prayer every day along with other prayer leaders assisting. Thank God Pastor Glenn, T. Renee Glenn will be leading prayer with us. It's going to be a powerful time. You don't want to miss these 14 days starting at 7 o'clock from 7 o'clock until 7:45 for 14 days. It's going to be a powerful time. We're going to be fasting from 6 a.m. Until 3 o'clock every day, 3 o'clock every day with just juices and fruit if you're able to do that. If you're under doctor's orders and you need to eat for medication and for health reasons, please, I'm encouraging you to do that. But those that can join me in this time of fasting for that time, will you do that? It's going to be a powerful time. We'll let you know what the Zoom numbers are going to be. We're not going to do it on Facebook, but we're going to do it on our Zoom page, our church's Zoom page. You can call in or you can come virtually in, but you'll be able to connect either by phone or by your smart device. It's going to be a powerful time in the name of the Lord these 14 days. Listen, beloved, we need prayer now like we've never needed it before. Like we've never needed it before. So much is going on. And the believer, I believe, we are the salt of the earth. We are the preservers. And I believe that God has committed that to us. That is our assignment, to pray for the peace of Jerusalem. But you've got some issues that you need to take to the throne of grace during this time. And I believe God's going to settle some things over these next 14 days of times of prayer. It's going to be a powerful time. So mark your calendar for that. And then I want to remind you that on the third Sunday and the fourth Sunday of October, we're going to have two back-to-back park and worship experiences on our parking lot on Sunday morning at 10 a.m. It's going to be great. We'll get a great time to see one another again. It's going to be powerful in the name. Right, so it's giving time, and we want to honor God in our giving. Tonight is your night to tithe. I'm going to ask you to prepare yourself to do that. You don't have to wait to Sunday to tithe. God has blessed you with increase, and this is your night to do it. Come on, let's pull out our phones, our smart devices, or our checkbooks if you're going to mail in your tithe and your offering. Let's do that. You can give by push pay, or you can give by your Cash App. You can give by text to give. And again, if you're giving to the Metro Church, that's TCP or Metro TCP. That's our DMV location. Please honor God in your giving there as well. Lord, we thank you for the opportunity to give tonight. We thank you for every seed that is sown. We thank you for the return back in our lives. I thank you, God, because in this season, you're giving us a swift return on our seed. Hallelujah. Glory to God. You're giving us a swift return on our seed. And I thank you that the corresponding seed returns quickly in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And we bless you. Amen. Come on, push send. Whatever God places on your heart to give, will you do that tonight? Amen. Give that 10, give that 15, give that 20, give that $100. God places upon your heart to give. Come on. You don't need a special night to give to the work of the Lord. All right. Give graciously. Put that envelope in the mailbox. And so the postman can pick it up in the morning and deliver it here to the church. Well, I bless God for you. Listen, meet us Sunday morning. Meet us Sunday morning, 10 o'clock. It's going to be a tremendous time in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And don't forget to share our broadcast with others, your family members on your page, that others can be blessed as you are blessed by the ministry of TCP. All right, I love you. Now the Lord bless you, the Lord keep you, the Lord make his face to shine upon you, the Lord be gracious unto you, the Lord lift up his countenance upon you, and may God give you peace, and may God bless your going out and your coming in until we gather again. In Jesus' name, thank God. Amen. Until the next time, bless you.